Shalom and welcome to Two Minutes of Torah. This year is entitled "The Message That We Must Learn from Zechariah ben Avkulis and Tisha B'Av," one of the most famous Gemaras in Shas. Bar Kamsa wants to get the Jews in trouble, so he tells the Roman government there that the Jews reject the government; they wouldn't even bring a korban on their behalf. And the Roman government sent an animal. Zechariah put a little blemish in the lip. And now the question is what to do about it. So the rabbi said, uh-oh, we can't bring such a korban. Wait a second, but we can, otherwise they're going to kill us. But Zechariah said, no. Halachically, you can't bring a korban like that. People are going to say that's allowed. It's going to be misleading. So they said, okay, let's just kill Bar Kamsa. No, what about someone who brings a bad korban with a blemish? Get killed. And the Gemara says that he was mistaken because of his humility. The house was destroyed and we were exiled. What's the message? There's many messages here, but I think one of them is that Rav Zechariah, who convinced all the rabbis, obviously he was a heavy hitter, they didn't see the full picture. They didn't see all of the trees. They didn't see the forest. They saw the tree, a specific tree called a korban with a blemish. Oh, korban with a blemish. What's the lachas of korban with a blemish? That's a very important topic to be involved in the lachas of korban and the blemish. What is a blemish? What's not a blemish? Are you allowed to bring it? Not allowed to bring it. But when there is something called the national destruction, you have a rodef, the Roman government is going to come and sack the whole nation, then that is called national pikuach nefesh. And that puts a different perspective on the blemish of the animal and whether you can bring it as a korban. But you have to see the forest. And here, the rabbis and Zechariah, they didn't see the forest. They saw the tree. And there's a message here for all generations, that even great rabbis, it's important to see every tree, every halacha, all the minutiae of halacha is crucial, but it's important to see the full picture as well. We need both, the micro and the macro. And you can have great rabbis, I think, today that see Eretz Yisrael, that see Am Yisrael, that see the full picture of what's going on. Then I think sometimes you have holy rabbis that see this halacha, you have chiv to learn. You have the halachas of nida, of mikvah, and this and that. But they don't see that there's a whole national renaissance here. And we're at the greatest period in 2,000 years. And there's binyan ha'aretz going on, and kibbutz galiot going on. We have to keep moving forward with this process. I think there's some holy rabbis that, just like Rav Zechariah, that don't see the full picture. And the message of that Gemara Tisha B'Av in all areas, but especially when it comes to Eretz Yisrael and national resurrection of the Am and Chas V'Shalom destruction of the Am, it's crucial to see the tree as well as the forest. Shalom.